how to use custom mobs of MCprep the right way. MCprep comes with a bunch of mobs, but there's so many good rigs out there. Why limit yourself? Like the Black Plasma rig? Go for it. Need a Warden rig? Why wait? You have two options, install your rig or set a custom folder. But first, let's spot check and fix our rig for MCprep. Open the file, and first make sure there is one collection per rig. Delete any other collections or simply rename them to collection so they don't show up in the MCprep UI. Now rename the collection of the rig. This is what will show up in MCprep. Next, select the armature, go into pose mode to find the rootmost bone, and then rename it to be root or master in edit mode, which enables the relocation options in MCprep to work. Optionally, clean up using F2 to rename objects. Now let's install the rig using option 1. In MCprep, reload rigs, and then click install rig. In the file browser, select the category you want to install it to, then select the file. Boop! You should see mob file installed. If you got contains no groups, then you didn't rename the default collection, or if in Blender 2.7, you didn't add the rig to a group. Now we can go into the category or search for it. Nice. Want to assign a snazzy icon? With the mob selected in the list, go into Advanced, Change or Install Mob Icon. Installing option 2. This is something I use all the time for longer productions like music videos, and is ideal when you have several customized rigs that you plan to reuse. First, create an assets or rigs folder in your local project, then create a subfolder for each category of rigs, or just have them all in one big folder. Next, move your blend files into these folders. Bonus points for adding an icons folder with PNG or JPEGs matching the rig collection names. Now in MCprep, we simply go under the spawner panel, mob tab, expand advanced, and click on the folder icon. Select your asset folder, and then after a moment, all your rigs should appear. Note how the category dropdown now matches the folders you've created. Finally, consider switching on library link after spawning, which means updates in your source rig file get read in everywhere else that it's linked. Final word of advice? I like to create copies or versions of my project rig files. If you place these in another lower subfolder and only have your master file in the root of each category folder, then you won't clutter up your UI. Looking for more information on mob spawning? Check out the older video here. Otherwise, happy blending.